Hey guys, the Esports Money TSM, MacTown, whatever you want to call me. Today we're going to be talking about Lycan and patch 6.82. I'm sorry, my hair looks crazy. So, obviously, Lycan's win rate has dropped pretty substantially in pubs. Not going to bring up the Dota buff right now. Actually, yeah, I'm not going to bring up the Dota buff. I'm now top 100 thanks to Dota buff's new algorithm, which is pretty cool. Not too surprised. It's actually like top 50 for a little bit. I think I might still be. But the hero is now very, very different. Not because of the way that the hero was changed, but the way that everything else in the patch was changed. The shapeshift nerf is pretty substantial, and the shapeshift speed increase from 522 to 650. It's pretty neat because it lets you rat better. It basically turns the hero to the ultimate rat, which is the way I played him anyway. However, Lycan is really, really, like, not good in the current meta because of the way, at least the way that I play him, because of the changes to experience in gold. Now, a lot of people will come out and say, well, obviously you've got the new map, which is weird, and the Roche Pit, which is weird. I don't know if that's good or bad yet, but you have the changes to Tier 1 towers. Now when everyone dies, the glyph is refreshed, which makes pushing much more difficult because the enemy will always, always, always glyph their Tier 1s now, if they're smart, or if they remember to. So that's a small nerf to him, but the biggest nerf to Lycan is, the way I play Lycan in pubs involves me killing Roche and then going to Ancients. This gets me a severe golden level advantage by continually farming the Ancients in addition to the lane. In fact, it gives me like a near professional level like advantage. Like you're just always higher level than everyone else in the game. This is no longer true because in patch 6.82, the way that changes in experience work. Now this is the way changes in experience in gold worked in 6.82. Now it's in 6.82c. It's mostly just the experience. The gold is pretty much back to where it was before. It's kind of similar to where it was before. But essentially, if you have two people in a lane versus two people in a lane, and those two people, if all four people are constantly dying and killing each other, and they all die an equal number of times, and they all get an equal number of kills and assists, and they fight a lot, they will be much higher level than they were before compared to patch 6.81. In fact, it's pretty substantial to the point where killing Ancients gives me a gold advantage just like I've always had. So there are a lot of games now, like my win rate's slipping a little bit. I haven't played enough to get a substantial change. It's 69, I think, 69% right now, 68 point something maybe, the lowest. But the big thing is, I still have that massive gold lead from killing the Ancients and switching to lanes to get last hits, but I no longer have that big of an experience lead. And one of the things that really made Lycan so dominant was that experience lead that you got from killing the Ancients and killing Roche. So I think that the thing, I don't know, I don't want to make balance suggestions because that's not really my thing. What I try to do is just analyze what is rather than try to beg for what could be. But if I could beg for what could be, I'd like to see the experience graphs change a little bit, or to see either jungle and or ancient experience increase, or to see creep experience increase, because you get more experience now if you're a substantially larger amount of experience now if you kill a higher level enemy. So everyone levels super, 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 super fast, and it really rewards an aggressive game, because even if you lose half the fights, as long as you're winning half of the fights, you're still leveling way faster than you would be before the patch. In fact, you'll be leveling faster than if you were sharing the lane with another person and just fighting. Like, two people sharing, like, normally the amount of time that it would take you to go back to base and you have to TP one way and you can walk one way from constantly fighting and dying in the lane would actually outweigh the experience benefits you get from kills. But now, because the experience from kills is so much bigger, that it's actually the other way around. Like, you almost always want to fight now, which is really counterintuitive to the way that I play Lycan and the way that I preach playing Lycan and other heroes, because I really like farming and I feel like I'm decent at farming. So that's Those are my thoughts on Lycan and the patch. That's why Lycan is weaker right now. That's also why Arteezy is still really good at Lycan, because Arteezy plays Lycan completely differently from the way I play Lycan. Arteezy plays Lycan in a style where he lanes and he fights a lot. He doesn't focus on getting an early Roche. He doesn't focus on killing Ancients all game. He does similar item builds that I do, but changes his skill build a bit. And though he does push, he's not as concerned with AFK farming as I am. So it doesn't affect his... It affects him a lot because of the ultimate nerf, and it affects him a lot because of the general nerf in Tier 1 towers. But the change in golden experience doesn't affect him as hard because he doesn't AFK farm the hero. He likes to fight with the hero. So those are my thoughts on Lycan. A lot of people have been asking me how I've been adjusting to the new patch. So I haven't been adjusting that well to it. He's still by far and away my strongest hero, and I want to practice laning him and experimenting with him in the lane, possibly doing Arteezy's mid, because then I can stack the Ancients, and if I'm stacking the Ancients, then I don't miss as much time from the lane, because now killing the Ancients is one of the... Now killing it, like before killing Ancients is 30 seconds, you could go to a fight and have a chance at missing the Ancients, or you could go at 30 seconds, kill them, waste another 30 seconds waiting for the Ancients to spawn, and then kill them a second time. Now you almost always want to show up right when it's time to pull, so you can kill another stack, because they don't give you as big of a reward as they used to, comparatively speaking. Like, they still give you the same money and experience, but the experience is worth less. Money's worth less, too, but money is much more similar now. So yeah, that's basically it. He needs to fight more now, or if you are AFK farming, you need to get towers earlier now. And getting those towers earlier is harder because of the changes to the map. So, yeah, those are my thoughts on Lycan for the current patch. This is a video I've been thinking about making for a few weeks now, but I really wanted to grind out at least, I don't know, 10 or 20 games of Lycan in the new patch, too. And now new patches, because we have B and 6.82B and 6.82C to compare it to. But yeah, I really hope that they either increase ancient slash neutral experience, or that they reduce the experience differential a bit, because it's really hurt AFK farming a lot. Like, now AFK farming is... Like, this is one of the reasons that this patch sees, like, pro teams drafting 3 cores, 2 cores plus a carry every game, because everyone's guaranteed to get levels. And because the games go on so long, everyone kind of gets money too, which is also bad for Lycan, because he's really good at hitting 30 minutes and having 600 or 700 GPM just by the virtue of pushing and farming without getting many kills at all. So, anyway, that's my opinion on Lycan in patch 6.82, 6.82B and C as well. Basically the same thing, not too many differences between those small patches. However, you can see that he's much weaker in this current metagame, because in 6.82B and C, he wasn't nerfed. So, thank you guys for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe. You can follow me on Twitch at twitch.tv/MacX10, and you can find me on Twitter @esportsmonies. Have a good day, guys. Peace.